Yep, yep, Easter, folks.
Hello, welcome to Straw Family Farm. I'm Christy.
I'm me.
You're the Easter Bunny.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, so. You got Starburst jelly beans.
Not
got...
one bag. Okay. Not two bags. Okay, not two bags. But. Three bags.
And then you got three things of Pete's, but you've already kind of gotten into one. You got the yellow and the pink of those. And then what did you get?
Fruit punch Pete's.
And it would not be Easter at our house without something fibery. So here's our little crocheted chicken. What is it? Under it's got a little egg in it. Yeah.
She laid an egg.
She laid an egg.
Hey, did you guys know there was a chicken that laid a triple yolk egg? Not once, but twice in a month. We have better odds of winning the lottery than seeing a triple yolk egg. The guy had a chicken do it twice. He should have played the lottery.
He should have.
And I got Tabby Patties.
Yes. So that's his stash for, I don't know, it'll last you quite a while, correct?
Yeah. I'm still working on my candy canes.
I know. Okay, so.
Good thing candy never goes bad.
I've got some stuff to get done over here cooking, so I'll be in and out. You, RJ, is going to entertain you as we go through the thing. What are you doing? What are we doing? Let's
see here. See this, folks. Easter egg coloring kit.
That's right. We are going to dye some Easter eggs. He'll probably start munching on some of this little, one of these bags, if you know RJ at all. All strawberry. The Easter Bunny knows what he likes, huh? Alright, so, in the chapel, and with great power gave the apostles witness of the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. Acts 4:33. So, I'm sure you know that we consider today even more special than Christmas. This is our big holiday. It means more to us just because we know we're going to live again. So, you guys take that to mean what you want it to mean. We're, of course, Christian. So, and he's after the cat. Alright, let's move on into barn stalls because we got a ton of stuff to do.
Alright. First, you get your snack. Or breakfast, or whatever you want to call it.
Or... breaking bread, as they say. Okay, so.
Got my little sandwich.
Man, it got crazy around here, didn't it? Who
Never.
All.
Never.
Who all this week only gave birth?
Did they get hers this week?
I don't. Please, Grandma.
Mama kept.
Let her have a drink. Come on. Okay.
Alright, folks. We had Fig, Pace, Favorite. What's that other one's name, Mama?
Favorite is Pace.
Annette? Corlette?
Annette.
Annette, that's what it was. Annette.
We've lost track.
Sister.
Sister's not a sheep.
No, but she had babies.
That's true. Let's back up. So, right. Fig had. Well, who was the first one to have them?
Fig.
Yeah, it was Fig. And then there was another one that had two black babies. Pace. Okay, so Fig had twins.
Yep, Pace had twins.
Pace had twins.
Favorite had twins.
Favorite had twins. And Annette had a single. So let's talk a little bit about Annette, because all those others are Shetlands. Annette is what?
Annette is a QT cross.
That's right. Now, it's the letters QT, okay? But we say it as in, oh, it's such a little cutie. Are you going to start dying from eggs? Oh, me.
You guys don't have any eggs.
Sorry. Okay. These are actually farm fresh stored in a store container, so. And one, just to be funny, is a duck egg. Hey, hey, hey. Come here. Everybody's beating
Not you, Moose.
Okay. So, That's why we don't need it plugged in. So, Annette is...
What are my options?
Whatever color.
Green.
There are six colors.
Oh.
One looks like orange, one looks like pink, red, blue, green, and yellow.
Oh.
So, anyway, so Annette, I said they look, I don't know.
Oh.
No. I said one looks orange, one looks pink, blue, green, red, and yellow.
I don't think there's a... Alright, let's see what this one comes. We'll know here in a second, folks. We have six options.
Green. So, anyway, Annette and the Cutie Crosses. They are my fiber sheep, and we use whatever RAM we want to put those properties back into. So, they started out with a Cotswold mom and a Southdown dad, right?
Yep.
And then we bred them back to a Southdown dad.
Yep.
Because it's Annette. Sally is 50-50. And
yep.
Annette is Sally's baby, right? So, Annette, or is she, no, who gave birth to the triplets? Oh, I heard it crack.
Oh, well. We can all have three for you.
Is Annette a half and half, or is she a three quarters? Remember?
She was out of...
Annette, Corlette, and Skin.
They're all three quarters.
So, huh?
Yeah, they're three quarters. They're out of...
Lester?
Yep.
Lester does. Okay. So, that means they're three quarters Southdown and a quarter Cotswold. And then this year, I ran a Gotland Ram on them. So, their babies will be three quarters Southdown, a quarter Cotswold, and half... Got
one? No.
No.
They'll be...
It'll reduce down, but we'll figure it
yeah.
out later and do it. Because it'll only make it a fourth Cotswold.
Won't even be a fourth.
Yeah. Anyway, we'll figure it out and do the ratios, but...
It'll be half just... got one.
And the rest will be cross. I think it's an eight. It's
an
like
eight.
3/8 and an eight.
Yeah, it'll be half Gotland, 3/8 Shetland, and not Shetland, Southdown, and an 8 Cotswold.
Yep. So, anyway, all right, so let's talk about, and let's see, how many breech births have we had this year?
Four.
Okay, so the first breech birth was, it started what, Friday?
Yep.
You went to roping practice, came home, and, Paige, who is also known as Favorite, her name is Paige, but he calls her his Favorite. She had gone into labor. She had a really bad looking discharge. And then, tell them what happened.
He
called Doc.
Yep.
And what did he say?
He said just to give her more time and wait. He said that discharge was normal sometimes.
Yep. He said some have it, some don't.
Yep.
And then... When you waited, what happened?
She had a lamb breech birth.
So you just kind of helped her? Or?
Yep.
Okay.
Kind of helped her along, and then she spit out another one a few minutes later.
Yep.
And it was normal.
And it came fast, didn't it? It was smaller, too, though, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. So.
All right.
And then... You went and worked cattle all day, which the job changed, right?
Yep. I was supposed to just work half a day, and then I ended up working a full day.
What happened with Festus?
Who?
The new goat.
Oh. While I was gone, Festus decided to stick his head through the fence. So he was stuck there for a while.
No, I think he'll get him out, but what did he do?
He smashed Mom's hand.
Twice
while she was trying to get him out. I mean,
like, smashed it so that they were shaking.
Uh-huh. Yeah, they were just a pig.
He really smashed it. And the thing is he did it right at the water trough for the cattle, instead of just going over the goat water trough and drinking out of it. So, yeah. I forgot what it's like to have goats that aren't big old pets sometimes. And by that I don't mean that he's wild or anything. It's just ours are super, super sweet, are they not? What are you doing over there?
Nothing.
Son, are you dying your eggs? Check your eggs.
Yeah, they're dying. Ugh.
You're a dork. So, anyway, but Festus isn't as easy handling as ours, and it's just because he was let to roam, right, son?
Yeah.
He did come up and he wanted the banana peels that I was working on, but he was almost too scared to take them, right? So, you could throw them out there and he'd eat them, but he's just not real sure of people. So, alright, and then last night, no more than you get in from working your double-time job, mm-hmm. I got the goat undone. I was processing bananas all day, and then... And we've had to do this big juggle thing, correct? Mm-hmm. RJ, you gonna come over here and show. And then this happened. You can come over here and hold it. You see here. I'm just gonna hook it right on the edge. There we go. What? They're all in frame. They're all in frame.
Nope.
There you go. Okay, so what happened? What happened?
Sister had babies.
Okay, who is sister? Moose, leave her alone. This is Ying, right?
Yep.
Put her up there. Don't, she sees her babies now, don't be mean. Okay, so tell the story about RJ was exhausted. We'd walked around and done stuff here on the farm as he got home, took care of them, and now she's blocking the camera. Here, good. Okay, can we move? Can they see? Here, move it over here. Move it over there. Yes. Move it over there. Oh, no.
Backfire, Mom.
Okay. Anyway, so we did a few things mm-hmm. on the farm. And we decided we were going to have what?
Pizza.
Just making sure I'm not messing with them. Okay. So... I got online and started looking for good deals, right?
Yep.
Because I didn't have any coupons, so you got to look online for coupon codes, correct?
Yeah. How do you know when the eggs are done?
Whenever they're the color you want them to be. Oh. You have to keep checking them. So, anyway. Hey, don't step on it. I see. Okay, that's a piece of food. Over here, Missy. Hey. Right there. Yes. Okay. Anyway, so... We hear this noise. Him and I were not paying attention, okay? The cats come and go as they darn well please, but it is what it is. And all of our boys are fixed, correct?
Yep.
So babies was not anywhere near on our mind. We thought they were honestly wormy. RJ and I had talked about getting something from the vet because they were really starting to look that pot-bellied look. And, So, you're all right. I'm right here.
I got dye on your counter.
I've got a mirror coloration.
Good deal.
So anyway, there's this horrible sound,
mm-hmm.
and we look over, and Moose had jumped on her and was getting her head, and I hollered at Moose and sent him on his way, and I told RJ, I said, go check her. I said, that was the oddest sound. And so, don't step on it, honey. Don't step. There you go.
She's still working out how to be a mom.
She is. What's the matter? You just want to be loved on. You want that heat. You want them to move so that you can have the heat and pad, huh? You don't need the heat and pad. You need to let the babies have it. So, anyway, when RJ, Don't play on them. Here we
Lay down. Yes, lay down. Lay down. There we go. All right. That's it right there. I know, we're not seeing anything, but I got to get her. She's
there we go.
There. Okay. There. Yes, you are. It's okay. It's okay. We got it. Look you there. We're just turning around backwards now because of the way you have it. There they are. Okay. Okay. I don't know what they're seeing, whatever he's seeing, but okay, there you go. Good girl. Yes. Good girl. She tries to be a good mama. Anyway, so, RJ jumps up. You're not helping me with the story, and I'm going to deal with the kittens.
I'm doing my eggs, Mom.
Too much going on. Okay, so, you jumped up and checked the cat, and he goes, oh my gosh, she's having a kitten, and I said, what? It just didn't process. And at this point, she stands up and starts hissing and running in circles trying to get the kitten. She's on concrete floor. And all I could see was, oh my God. So we got a hold of her, got her calmed down, got her laid down, grabbed the blankets that we had for the sheep, right? That were washed and ready to go out to the barn, and put her on that. And RJ was a good daddy, and he. It's okay. It's okay. He is.
That explains why. I need more water in this cup. It didn't cover my egg. That's why my yellow didn't do right. Mom set me up for failure, guys. Why only half my egg is covered.
There you go. Put as much water in there as you want. I measured just it out. What it is there. It's a thinner,
powder cup.
That's not my fault.
Anyway, all right, keep going. What happened, son?
All right. So.
She does the circling thing, hissing, right? We grab the sheep.
Grab the kitten. The cat. Grab the cat. And Mom gets a little kitten.
And what can we find out?
Mom didn't know how to cut an umbilical cord.
Well,
none of us did.
Which ways was it coming out?
It was coming out breached.
Yes. So, and we've never had to cut one. Our mamas, even our bad mamas, normally take care of that. Alright? So, we grabbed the dental floss, and what happens then?
Google said to tie a piece of dental floss around the umbilical cord.
And yes, we Googled it.
Yes, we Googled it. And then cut it on the mama's side.
Yep, about an inch away from.
So, Mom did that.
Now what happened, son?
The cat ate the dental floss.
Yep, when she went to licking on the baby.
She went to licking and cleaning on the baby, she ate the dental floss.
Well, first she did what to the baby?
First she tried to eat the baby, thinking it was a mouse.
So
we had to stop her.
She like grabbed it by its head. And
yeah, she grabbed it and was trying to like shake it and stuff.
If it hadn't been so scary in the moment, oh my God, is this really happening? It would almost have been funny, correct?
Yeah.
Because we kind of chuckle about it now. Here we are, we burst up all the time. I used to work for a shelter. We just were not ready for that to happen here. You know, when I was at the shelter, I could handle it, no problem. Here, I wasn't ready. All of our little boys are fixed, you know? The big dogs keep the stray cats away. They chase everything. We've never seen a stray cat. Nothing, have we, son?
No.
And so, I don't know. We don't know, you know?
Yep.
It's just that simple. We don't know. So, anyway, and RJ, what did we keep saying after everyone?
All right, Mama, that's enough. You can stop now.
To a point where you said what?
Return to sender, return to sender.
The Pez dispenser.
Oh, yeah. I called her a Pez dispenser.
No, he said get away from her rear.
I said, everybody get away from her rear. She thinks she's a Pez dispenser.
Yep. So, anyway, but in the end, she had four. How many were breached?
Three.
So, of the four breached births that we spoke about, one was a sheep, right?
Yep.
And three was the cat. So, she didn't have any problems having them breached. It just kind of made her...
with its feet up against her mama's butt, pushing to get out of it.
Yep.
So, aw. Anyway, they're awfully sweet, aren't they, Mama? And she's getting the hang of it. It took us a little bit to get her to lay down and let them suck, right?
Yep.
By the fourth one, though, honestly, she got the hang of it. Like, she bit the umbilical cord. She took care of it. She only ate two placentas, correct? The other two she didn't. And honestly, that's, well, having to watch that, that's gross. So, but that's okay. So, they're all doing good, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And there is my little varmint. And what is wrong with all these varmints? Why are these kittens in a box on my counter, son? Let's go there. So.
Because of these things over here.
Mm-hmm.
Let me show you.
Oh, I already did.
No. Of why they're on the counter.
Yes, I already did.
Oh, I thought you... Never mind.
I already did. He's not even watching where that camera goes. Sit down and do your eggs, boy.
I spent.
So, Moose tried to attack them, correct?
That's not pink.
Rascal tried to... Then what is it? Maybe it's supposed to be purple. Maybe you're supposed to let it soak a long time. I don't know. Don't look at me.
I know what it is.
Rascal tried to attack them, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Sister and Hank did really good, didn't they?
Yeah. Hank came down and saw him.
Yeah, she laid there and watched him for the longest time. The only thing is that Sister, or Yank, we just call him Sister and Fatso now, so.
We used to call him the kittens. Now we can't do that, I guess. Because the kittens had kittens.
Yeah. Anyway, and then I tried to put them upstairs and what happened, son?
It was too cold.
Yeah, we don't have central heat in the air. The stove isn't up there. And what's the weather doing?
It's turning cold.
That's not an April Fool's joke, is it?
No.
Mother Nature thinks she's funny. Alright, so let's move on to mini fences. Did we get anything fixed today or this week?
Well, we got a hand getting fixed right now. Mom is fixing some cheese.
Cheese tray.
Yep.
Mashed potatoes.
Fish gravy.
Corn gravy. So we're fixing some good food.
Yep.
But no real complications.
No.
Okay. In the yarn farm, advertisements going out for the April 7th thing. We're hoping that it's not cold, right?
No.
Anything else? I really haven't done too much out there. Shearing, right? We've been shearing.
Yep.
Got to get the blades sharpened. We're going to take them in Monday. Have them done, right?
Yep.
Okay, and then get back to shearing. And who all did you get sheared so far? Not even half of them, huh?
No, I think I got 9 sheared.
You only have 1 goat left to go, right?
Yeah, I only have 1 goat left to go, and the rest are sheep, so.
I think that's really all that's been going on in the yarn farm. I haven't gotten a whole lot done. I haven't been able to work on my rug or anything like that, right? What else?
Hey, you're about to...
Alright. I guess move on into... In the farmhouse? No, in the garden. Which I haven't gotten anything done out there either. I haven't even mowed. So, nothing in the fields. A bunch of things blooming.
Yep.
Including a blooming idiot. I've always wanted to say that. April Fools. Alright. In the farmhouse. What's going on in the farmhouse? Easter?
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Can you tell about your job?
Yeah.
That happened this week.
Mm-hmm.
And it even got, and you even got a promotion this week.
No, I just got my hours doubled this week.
Oh. Okay. So, I call that a promotion.
Tell them how it went.
Well, Mom had a job. She went on an interview, and
it's just a housekeeping job.
Yeah, it's just a housekeeping job.
It's a part-time...
Part-time gig, you know?
They're
day and a half a week.
Here, right?
Yeah, it's day and a half a week. I think is what she said, something like that. Day and a half, 2 days.
2 days a week.
2 days a week, that's what it was. 2 days a week. All right. So, Monday, Mom went, and it,
No, it was Tuesday. Because she had an appointment, she couldn't move Monday. So, it went Tuesday.
Tuesday.
Yep. Alright, and what happened Tuesday?
Mom went, she worked, came home. Laid on the couch. I actually made dinner.
Yep. Okay.
Then,
Wednesday. Oh, didn't we go on our road trip?
We went on our road trip.
You forgot to talk about that, and we already
We'll come back to it.
Okay. Thursday.
Oh, hang on there.
Sorry about that. Okay, so.
Sorry about that, guys. We interrupt this program. Now it's back to your regular scheduled program.
Okay, so. Thursday, I get a phone call. Now, she had asked me, she already had an obligation on Friday afternoon. She said, can you come before Easter and help me get things set up for her family? I said, sure, no problem. It was just going to be half a day on Friday. And then I'd start the next week doing Monday and Fridays only. So, Thursday I get a phone call from her son. And he asked, would you mind doing my house too? And so... He asked me if I could come Tuesday and Thursday, and I told him the next 2 weeks my Tuesdays are taken up because I scheduled around his mom. And she said, okay. He said, okay, what about Wednesday and Thursday? So I'm going to go to his house on Tuesdays and Thursdays after the first 2 weeks. The first 2 weeks will be Wednesday and Thursday, get all of his laundry done, his house cleaned up, all that stuff, correct?
Yep.
So, yeah. It kind of went from 1 day to 2 days to 4 days in a week. So I know I'm doing the right thing when it's all going good, right?
Oh.
Okay, so if you follow us on YouTube, mm-hmm. I know some people just watch podcasts, that's fine. But
you're missing out, folks.
No, not always. Mm-hmm. Some of them are short, some of them are long, some of them just don't have time. So, some people just have the podcast that tells them everything that went on during the week. But Wednesday...
Well, at least they're getting all of this
right here. Uh-huh. Anyway, we went on a special trip Wednesday. Where do we go?
That way.
South.
Yeah.
To whose house?
Incoming, intruder, can't open the door, intruder alert.
Okay, so we headed south to Biddy Boo Brown is her channel.
Yeah.
But her daughter is Katie, and Katie is the...
Contest winner.
That's right. So we went down there, but it was a dual purpose, because what did they have down there?
They had a goat.
That's right, a billy goat. Yay! So, it's my coffee. Do not dye anything in my coffee.
These dyes are non-toxic, right?
I don't know, and I don't want to find out. So, anyway, we went down there, and we got our billy. Mm-hmm. You know you can put them back in if you're not happy with it.
I hung it up.
He's stuck.
Okay. That's good.
They have their spots, Mom.
Okay. Anyway, so we went down there and got what?
A go you. A yo go.
Yep.
I'm gonna go. Oh, I dripped on my egg.
Okay, I got a question for you. There was 10 eggs to die, right? Hmm. You only have 9 places to put them.
Yeah. Well, I set this up. This little pink thing.
Huh.
I put it together, Mom.
And I'm fixing it, Sonny.
Oh, I did it backwards. Whoops.
There you go.
That's how that works. I thought it was looking like a little fishy.
Anyway, so we went down there and we got our goats, right? And you got to talk to Katie. You gave her a book and stuff so that she could start learning all about sheep, right?
Yep.
And we ate dinner, right?
Yep.
Lee, when you go through, you let the big dogs out. They're upstairs.
Yes, ma'am.
I think. And then one of them left us a treasure out by the skull head. Can I get you to take care of that too, please?
This one turned out good.
They all turned out good because they're done by you.
No, this one didn't. It looks good.
Well, find a different color and put it in it.
I don't like that color.
Okay, so.
Hey, dump some of that color in something. See what it does.
I was going to say, you want to put it in this one?
Yeah, do it.
Take that sun out, or you're not going to have room for the egg. There you go. Alright. Gonna take that off. Nobody said we were, you know, great with this, huh?
Mom's better with yarn.
Yep. Anyway, so, we went and got our Billy, and what's his name? Matthew.
Oh.
And he had a traveling partner, and what was his name?
Festus.
Why can you remember Festus and not Matthew?
Because he's Festus!
No, they're off the show Gunsmoke.
Yeah.
Matt Dillon?
Mm-hmm. I remember Festus, though.
Why can't you remember Matthew?
Because Festus is a cool name. I always want names on Festus.
Not festive, Festus.
Close enough. We hope that's no difference.
You're a dork. Alright, so, anything else going on in the front house?
Well, Dad keeps cutting through my shot.
Oh, why? Are you scared he's going to steal your enthusiasm there?
No, I'm scared he's going to try to, like, wear it down with his grumpiness.
That could be. Alright. So, I have no idea why he's over there gasping for air. Anyway, anything else going on? Alright, so tell them about the big kitty shuffle real quick, because we left that out. We got off track.
The big what?
Kitty shuffle.
Oh. Yeah, we had the mommy cat down
here. When everything was pinned, we had her down here, as long as Moose is put up, and Rascal. But she protects him from Rascal.
Yep.
Rascal tried to get in there and assist. I'm not sure about the assistance, but you know what I mean. Hey, did you bite one of those? He's eating the Starburst. They're called Crazies. Are they two in one?
Yeah, you can taste the outside the different flavor on the inside.
Bite one in half and let us see. There, it says they're two flavors in one.
See?
Show them, not me.
How you do it?
I don't want to get your slimy stuff on my hands. Just show it up there to the counter.
Yellow and gray.
Okay. Anyway, so we had them down here last night. They did okay. But then Mama wants to wander and come into my bed and sleep, which I'm not going to deter her from that. She needs a break from sitting sometimes, right? And they have a heating pad. So they were fine down here because this is where the heat is, the stove, blah, 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 right?
Yep.
Then I had to get the dogs out. So what happened? Where did I try putting them in?
Upstairs with the big dogs. The big dogs won't mess with them.
Well, Hank won't mess with them.
Right.
But he came in.
Jethro.
So we have to kind of take that. And it was getting cold up there, correct?
Yep.
Okay. So we couldn't really have them down there. Up there.
Right.
So what have you come up with on these kittens?
They're going to go in my room. I already have a kennel in there, so we're going to slide the box in the kennel and let them stay in there.
You knew that's why I got all these bananas, right? So I'd have these boxes just for these beds, right? You know that's what happened.
Yeah.
Hey, everything works for a reason. God has a plan. I got all
these big boxes.
With all those bananas, and I'm almost done processing all of them. And Rascal, he's
what
trying to open
my.
It was pink or whatever.
That was orange. The blue.
Not working out, so this one's dead.
Yep.
Alright. We're not talking much to the camera. Are we done? It's actually starting to rain. Alright. So, for the record, in this house, we don't use bleach, right? So
we don't.
No. Well, can you have bleach? Are you allowed to have bleach?
Nope.
So, for those who wonder about removing dyes from cabinets, you just take these miracle erasers.
Wow. It's a miracle.
You do have to scrub a little more than what they say on the box. It doesn't just come right off.
Does too.
Yeah, but not just wipe it down. Like when bleach touches it, it goes away.
Oh.
And then you actually have to keep wiping over it until it's gone.
It's gone now.
I can see where it was.
Nobody else can.
That they can't. Okay, are you done with these other two?
Hang on. You can take the yellow, I guess.
You can take the yellow. Okay.
No, wait. Bring it back. Thank you.
Put your yellow one in. It was only half done. Put it back in there.
Yeah, I know. That's what I see.
So, anyway. All right. RJ's. You stop dropping them in. I can hear it crack. You're a meathead. We're gonna get off of here and get this stuff cleaned up and get our kittens. Okay. Don't step on it. Okay. There we go.
Look at that baby. Look at that baby. Aww. Yes.
Alright. I don't even know if it's focusing. But anyway, alright. We're off of here. We will talk to you guys later. RJ, didn't you have a big announcement to make?
I did.
Yep. We won $1 million. April Fool's.
Oh. Yeah.
Today is April Fool's Day, too.
Yeah.
It's RJ's very own holiday.
Yeah, they named it just for me.
Yep. All right, so I'm going to get off of here. We will talk at y'all later. Bye.
Yeah.